Resolution of both houses number 6, which seeks to conduct charter change via a hybrid constitutional convention, may have secured the approval of the lower house, but it may face rough sailing at the Senate. Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri says opening up charter change debates could lead to an overhaul of the constitution and even a different form of government.
I really believe in the sanctity and the wisdom of having a Senate, a bicameral system of government. And if it means my head, then so be it. I mean, so be it. But not on my watch, where I'm sitting here.
Still, Zubiri says Senator Robin Padilla, who is chairman of the Committee on Constitutional Amendments and Revision of Codes, can still conduct his Chacha consultations. But Zubiri is quick to point out the majority of senators are opposed to Chacha.
I don't think we have 18 votes to dance the cha-cha. Hindi kami makasayaw ng cha-cha. Wala kaming numero para malaman ng taong bayan. 18 boto kailangan ng ating mga kasamahan sa Senado para umunsad ang charter change. So, for us, it's moot and academic. We might as well focus on the DAC priority measures which will help solve the problem of inflation, smuggling.
Administration Senator J.V. Ejercito says only 4 to 5 senators are supporting charter amendments.
So I have to be honest that in pag nag-uusap kami, especially sa lounge, hindi pa namin masyado na pag-usapan.
Senator Ronald De La Rosa admits he is one of the 5 pro-Chacha senators, but he only wants revisions to economic provisions.
Sabi ko nga, if magiging exercise in futility ito, dahil nga hindi kami makakuha ng numbers, so I might as well go with the majority.
Senate Minority Leader Aquilino Pimentel III says the original PDP laban supports charter change, but they won't back superficial amendments.
Ang problema, kung nakaka-encounter kami ng proposal to change the constitution, but the economic provisions, hindi kami... If we are true to the PDP laban basic principles and objectives, hindi po yun ang aming, hindi po economic provisions. It's really more of political provisions.
While Senate Majority Leader Joel Villanueva hopes to first see the results of the newly approved economic laws before considering Chacha. Padilla is unfazed. The first time senator believes a defeat on the floor doesn't mean it's the end.
Ako po, makarating lang ako sa plenaryo kay bumoto ng 23 yan na laban sa CONAS o sa charter change. Makarating lang ako sa plenaryo, I'm happy. Meron pa naman susunod na 20th Congress. O kung ako pa rin ang chairman ng committee na to, di ipa-file ko lang uli. Ganun naman. Hindi, no surrender po talaga ito. Importante, tuloy-tuloy.
Despite the pale support of their colleagues here in the Senate, Senator Robin Padilla will continue his public consultations regarding charter change. And on Friday, he will be in Cebu and will be accompanied by Senator Ronald De La Rosa, not just to listen to the people, but to extend his support to his party mate. Sharian Torres, ABS-CBN News.